Look at that. Uh-oh.
This is Trooper.
Hey, Trooper, come here.
And Trooper has come a long way since last year. The Humane Society of Missouri is dedicated to providing second chances to all animals in need. In this program, we will take you into the secret and disturbing world of substandard puppy mills. Watch as these little cowardly lions transform into wonderful companions.
It's funny how this little creature has given me so much more happiness and, you know, just her little smiling face every day, it helps you get through the day.
You'll also meet Rory. But don't let this three-legged dog fool you.
She plays hard, she sleeps hard, she trained hard.
We'll take you out to the Long Meadow Rescue Ranch in Union, Missouri, for an up-close look at what they have going on. Get a sneak peek at the new Best Buddy Pet Center, and much more.
Whoa!
Society of Missouri Second Chances Telethon. I'm Virginia Kerr.
And I'm Kathy Warnick, President of the Humane Society of Missouri.
And this is Rocco and this is Peanut. And the Humane Society of Missouri helps so many animals like them every year. During this broadcast, you'll see heartwarming tales of rescue and adoption, and you may even see some of your own pets on the screen behind us.
And you'll learn why your help is critical in making these second chances possible.
Second chances for animals like Harley, who was rescued from a puppy mill in 2010.
And Sparrow, an adorable kitten who needed an emergency eye surgery.
And you'll get an update on Trooper's story along with a trip out to Trooper's new home.
We'll take you out to Long Meadow Rescue Ranch, a state-of-the-art horse and farm animal rehabilitation center located near Union, Missouri.
You're going to meet Rory, a cute little three-legged dog, and Minnie, a six-year-old chihuahua.
See the lengths that we go through to give these and so many more animals the second chances they deserve.
Now, before we jump into our first story, I want to point out the fabulous group of volunteers behind us at our phone bank right over there. They are here for you, so please keep them busy and make those phones ring. And here's another reason to call and donate. Kathy, tell them the exciting news.
That's right, Virginia. We are very excited to announce that our great friends at Scott Trade have once again agreed to match all donations during this broadcast, up to $25,000. So your gift will count double. Call our toll-free number, 877-803-0078, or make a secure donation online at hsmo.org. Your gift will go twice as far and help twice as many animals in need.
That is wonderful, Kathy. And just to give you even more reasons to donate, a gift of $50 gets you this adorable Humane Society of Missouri dog leash. Donate $100 for this I Love Shelter Pets tote bag, or take both items home with a gift of $150. And you may remember hearing all about, you know, Trooper, the brave puppy who made a miraculous recovery after being dragged on a highway for more than a mile. Well, stay tuned to see how he's doing more than a year after his rescue.
Thanks very much to our generous Second Chances sponsors, Scott Trade, Purina, HeartGuard Plus, Frontline Plus, Kuhlman Design, and AT&T. Please support the products and services of these generous companies who are helping abused and homeless animals every day.
Our first story is about a dog who gained international fame after he survived being dragged behind a truck for more than a mile. Trooper spent more than a year recovering at the Humane Society of Missouri. His adorable face and personality touched so many lives here and throughout the world. Trooper is now a happy, healthy dog who is an ambassador against animal abuse. KMOV News 4's Jasmine Huda recently caught up with the key players in his rescue. Let's take a look at his inspiring story.
The story of Trooper is, I imagine, one of the biggest ones you've ever been involved with, would
definitely,
you say?
Definitely.
Let's take us back to the early stages, because you have a firsthand account of Trooper in the very beginning.
Yes.
Take us back to when this happened. This was November of 20, this was around Thanksgiving.
Yes, it was the day before Thanksgiving of November 2012. And I was driving my territory, going through my normal day-to-day, and received a call from our dispatcher saying that a police department got a call from a woman that there was a puppy being drugged down Highway 55.
Is this like an ER situation?
Anytime we have a trauma, but especially with Trooper, because his was so extensive, his injuries, we contact our veterinary medical center and our exam rooms in the shelter and prepare them for what we're bringing. Once I got there, it was immediate. The veterinarian was at the exam table along with two veterinary technicians, and they had supplies ready to start treatment.
He was in awful condition. I mean, he was physically badly injured, and of course was in shock. And it was very questionable at that point whether the injuries would be treatable, but he was taken to our Maryland Heights facility, and Dr. Wright and Dr. Schivelbein were the two veterinarians who provided that immediate care. And quite frankly, a big part of that immediate care was controlling his discomfort. He was in agonizing pain, which fortunately we were able to control.
When you first saw him, did you think he would make it?
Well, you know, you never can underestimate the will to live that we find in some animals. I certainly wasn't sure, and as is always the case at the Humane Society, it takes a team effort, and the team was really going to give him every opportunity to show us just what he was capable of doing, and he certainly did that quite well by pulling through.
Would you say he had the spirit?
Absolutely. I mean, he's well named. Trooper is named because he was a trooper and is a trooper, and yes, that had a lot to do with it.
The first thing we did was canvass the area. I took another investigator and myself, and we went door to door from the starting point of where this person lived and canvassed the entire neighborhood, talked to all the neighbors, tried to figure out any information as to whose dog it may be, if anybody recognized the dog. But the real break in the case came when we were in the back of the apartment building where the person that was driving lived, and I looked up and I saw the cameras.
Were you making much headway just talking to neighbors? Have you seen this? Have you heard anything? Did they?
None of the neighbors were able to provide us with any information, so we were really hitting a brick wall up until the time that we were able to locate the surveillance video.
What did that surveillance video show?
It showed a vehicle pulling up in the alley approximately 11 or so at night. A person got out of the back seat of the four-door vehicle, walked a dog up to the truck, and then tied it around the back trailer hitch of the truck, then got back in the vehicle and left. As they left, the dog came out on a lead's length away from the back part of the truck and was just looking at him as they drove away. Oh. They came back a second time, and the dog again came out from underneath the truck, looked at him, they stopped, and then they kept going. It was heartbreaking because we knew what was going to happen to the dog. It's like reading the end of a book before you read the first part. You know what's going to happen. You just didn't know how it happened. But just knowing that every time that car came by, he came out looking at the car, wanting to go back into the car. And then when the driver comes out in the morning, walks around the truck, you're just wanting the dog to come out. Trooper, wake up, go out from behind the vehicle, show yourself. I almost wanted to climb through the screen and just drag the leash out, say, come here, buddy, let's go, just to save him from that. But you couldn't. And it's unfortunate that it has to happen to an innocent animal. He didn't do anything to deserve that. All he was doing was being a dog. And that was his only crime. And for that, he's dragged at 55 miles an hour down a highway for over a mile. Our break came when the person that owned the truck and trailer saw the video, said, I know whose car that is. It was his ex-wife, and he recognized a person taking the animal to the back of his truck, tying the dog up to the back bumper and getting back in the car. I said, "Are you sure that this is her vehicle?" "I'm positive." So by the end of the night, I had a picture of the vehicle, had the license plate number, and by the time Friday night came around, we had all the information that we needed. Monday morning, we presented it all to the police department.
Well, when I first met him, he was pretty much just a puppy laying in a cage, but you could see a little bit of spirit. I mean, he was completely bandaged from head to toe, but anytime you went to say hi to him, you'd see that little tail just start wagging, and he just wanted to be nice to people.
And because of his physical condition, there were limitations, but you guys were able to make it possible for him to be as normal of a dog as he could be.
Sure.
What did you do?
Well, we played with him. He is enamored with every single toy that's ever been made. He loves everything, especially, you know, fluffy toys he could tear apart. He loved chasing the ball. We taught him fetch. We would just let him kind of expend some of that puppy energy. He was just so smart. You could see from early on, you could teach him anything, especially if you had, you know, a toy or even a little bit of string cheese.
Is that pretty? String cheese, right.
Yes.
So he's a big fan of.
Oh yeah, he's a cheese lover, and really any kind of cheese, but string cheese is really easy because you can take it off in little pieces and really train him. He can literally learn tricks in 5 minutes, given positive reinforcement and something to work for, like a piece of cheese.
Did you say he was your office dog?
He was my work dog. I have my two dogs at home, and he was my dog when I came to work. Every day I would come in and I would go get him, and we'd go for a nice walk, and then he would come up into my office and we'd play a little bit. His favorite game was hallway fetch.
What was the biggest challenge that you had when he was in your care?
I think people, after he was healed, everybody still wanted to almost treat him like a victim, and he capitalized on that. He could really weasel anything out of anybody with his charm, and everybody would say, "Oh, well, it's okay, he can have my donut, it's Trooper," and I would say, no, he needs to learn his manners just like any other dog does.
You know, you described Trooper as your work dog, and in many ways, he was your dog for a good part of the day. What was it like, you know, having this dog who you became so close to, and then, you know, you begin the adoption process? Yeah.
When Trooper was adopted out, I was ecstatic. Because I've seen him waiting for that perfect opportunity for his perfect forever home. I thought I was gonna be a mess being sad, but I realized this is the absolute best thing that could have ever happened to him. And Greg is a wonderful person and spoils Trooper to the ends of the earth. So that made me so much happier. And the fact that I'm able to keep in touch with them really helps out too.
To me, the rescue is not complete until the animal is adopted, because that's that final piece when you know, okay, my job is done, and then I can turn my attention to, you know, the next animal that needs help.
This was a dog who's known around the world, and talk about the demand, what it was like, and just how much interest there was in Trooper.
We had a process set up, you know, people would go online, they'd fill out their application, and then we would start looking at those answers, and we kind of had a multi-stage process. So we would pull out those that we thought whose lifestyle maybe would be best suited to Trooper and his ongoing needs, because of course, he's the star. And so we did that, and we narrowed it down, and then we brought people in for, you know, face-to-face interviews. And for those people, I think it was like winning the lottery, just getting to that part, because they got to meet Trooper. Mm-hmm. And you know, even if they weren't chosen maybe as his adopter, they're one of a handful of people who can say, "I got to play and spend time with Trooper." So that was fun to watch too. And then it came down to, okay, you know, who do we think is gonna be the best match? And that it'd be a good match for both parties, you know, so that they really enjoy having Trooper as a companion for the rest of his life. And I think we're so fortunate
with the person that we ultimately chose to be his adopter, and just a gentleman whose personal characteristics, you know, kind of easygoing and accepting, but, you know, fairly active and having the time and I think the mindset to devote a lot of that time to Trooper and his happiness, and I'm just so thrilled with Greg, the person who is now Trooper's owner, and I see the bond that they're beginning to form, and it's just overwhelming. I think how lucky are we that he came forward.
And caring for Trooper, this is a dog with some very special needs, and that comes at a cost. And fortunately, I understand the Humane Society is taking on part of that.
We all have a lot emotionally invested in Trooper, and we want to do anything and everything we can to continue the happy ending. It's not an ending at this point, it's a happy continuation, but yes.
So any of his follow-up visits or any issues that might need to be addressed, Humane Society will
absolutely take care of, yeah, at no cost to his new owner, absolutely.
I think that puts his owner at peace of mind, and really everyone, all of Trooper's fans and everyone who adores him from across the globe.
Absolutely. I mean, there have been too many issues to worry about up until now. Now we should enjoy it, and by removing the medical issues from the table, yes, that should make life a lot more comfortable for everybody.
When you see him now,
it's amazing. You know, it shows how much we can do for the animals here. He never, you know, nobody thought that he would not only survive but keep the leg and become as much of a joy as he has brought to everybody who he's touched. You know, he's a big goofy puppy, and if he didn't have the scars, you have no idea that his life started out like this.
You can really feel the love this team has for Trooper and other abused animals just like him. Caring for injured, defenseless dogs like Trooper is no easy job. You saw how much work went into his recovery, and that recovery would not have even been possible without you. And Trooper's rescue, Kathy, must have cost the Humane Society thousands of dollars. So tell me how a telethon like this can help save other animals.
The happy outcome of Trooper's story really was a full year in the making. This brave dog suffered heartbreaking abuse. He endured 8 surgeries and numerous laser treatments. Through it all, he remained a sweet and loving puppy. Trooper's rescue, the investigation leading to a conviction, and all the care Trooper received cost the Humane Society of Missouri thousands of dollars. And we are committed to paying for his continuing medical needs. Your donations make this possible. For Trooper and thousands of other animals just like him. Please donate now and make second chances possible for all the animals just like Trooper who so desperately need you.
Well, and the fact that Scott Trade is matching all donations up to $25,000, that is going to make a huge difference.
It absolutely does. And here taking donations, as he does every year, is the CEO of Scott Trade, our very good friend, Roger Riney.
At Scott Trade, we love animals, and it's exciting for us to be able to help. The Humane Society of Missouri is such a special organization because they help more animals than any other organization we know of. That's why, again this year, Scott Trade will be matching all donations up to $25,000. This means that anyone who contributes to the Humane Society of Missouri will be doubling their donation.
Well, you have to tell me, how much fun is it to answer the phones and hear from these people who want to help out?
I do this every year, and it is always a good time. I truly enjoy talking to people who are passionate about the well-being of animals.
Thank you so much, Roger. Scott Trade's support means an incredible amount to the Humane Society of Missouri. We hope everyone will call right now and have their donation doubled by your very generous gift.
And you may not know this, but the Humane Society of Missouri receives no money from tax dollars. They don't get funding from other animal welfare agencies or the United Way. And just for this program, the generous people at Scottrade will match whatever amount you can give, up to $25,000. So your donation will be doubled. And we want to thank all of you who supported Trooper through his long recovery. Your support made all the difference for him. And now we need your help supporting the many other victims of animal abuse. And you can call at any time during this program. Volunteers are standing by at our phone bank right now. You can charge your donations on Visa, MasterCard, Discover, or American Express. Our toll-free number is 877-803-0078. And you can make a secure donation on the website, hsmo.org, and help ensure that the Humane Society will be there when dogs like Trooper need them the most. And stay tuned, because later in the program, we will visit Trooper at his new home and we'll meet his family.
Scottrade knows our clients trade and invest their own way.
With Scottrade Smart Techs, I can quickly understand my charts and spend more time trading. Their quick trade bar lets my account follow me online so I can react in real time. Plus, my local Scottrade office is there to help, because they know I don't trade like everybody. I trade like me. I'm with Scottrade.
Ranked highest in investor satisfaction with self-directed services by J.D. Power & Associates.
I'm Scott Bakula, or you may know me as Dr. Samuel Beckett, Quantum Leap's time-traveling physicist, or Jonathan Archer, captain of the Starship Enterprise and keeper of Porthos, the Beagle. And I don't just play a dog owner on TV. My two pups, Cooper and Chloe and Houdini the cat, who incidentally were all rescued, bring so much happiness to my life, which is why I'm proud to support the Humane Society of Missouri in my hometown, St. Louis. Each year, the Humane Society of Missouri helps thousands of animals through their rescue, veterinary, and adoption programs. They save dogs and cats from the streets and put them in loving homes. And they do all of it without government assistance. If you're a pet lover like me, I hope you'll show it by making a donation right now. Support the Humane Society of Missouri. Can you imagine how difficult things would be for animals in need if the Humane Society weren't around to help? Oh boy. Call now to pledge your support, and thank you.
If your dog can dream it, Purina Pro Plan can help him achieve it. Purina Pro Plan's bioavailable formulas deliver optimal nutrient absorption. Purina Pro Plan, nutrition that performs.
What would you do if you found a stray dog or cat? Maybe some of you would hold on to it, look for the owner, and even eventually keep it as your pet. But thousands of other strays are not lucky enough to find a forever home. They hide under porches or in alleys, digging through trash to find anything to eat. They become injured, they get in fights, they carry disease, and sometimes can even threaten children and adults. Worst of all, many are abused at the hands of humans. The Humane Society of Missouri has always been a safe haven for stray and unwanted animals. But in the past several years, they've seen a real crisis in the number of strays brought to their shelters. Since 2009, the Humane Society has experienced a 46% increase in stray animals. It's cost them more than $4 million to care for them all. Watch now to learn what has to be done to end St. Louis's stray animal crisis and how you can help.
Well, I think people should care about all creatures, whether it's human or canine or feline, because caring about all creatures means you care about people. And we, as a human race, bred these animals to be our companions, and they're not our companions when they're running the street without a family or a home to call their own. And there he goes. That's 3,800 block of California now.
In 2010, the city made a rather drastic decision, essentially that they stopped providing a lot of animal control service that they had previously provided to the city. What that meant to the animals and our citizens is that they no longer accepted stray animals. they no longer accepted unwanted pets.
I would see strays in every corner of the city, in every scenario. I would see them eating out of dumpsters. I would see them running scared down a busy road. I would see them looking to people for help and almost looking as if they're trying to recognize somebody or someone from maybe a home that they once had, but they'd been living on the street so long that they just didn't know what else to do except run away and just try to survive. And that was one thing I would always try to do, even though it wasn't technically my job to pick up strays. If I saw one out there, I just in my heart couldn't leave him on the street, not at least giving it a try and seeing if he would come to me and offer him some food and see if he would maybe come where it's warm or where it's cool.
Hi, what's she doing? No? Do you want cookie?
Since that period of time, we have provided that service at a cost of more than $4 million. And of course, Humane Society of Missouri receives no tax dollars, no government support in any way, and we have to rely on our supporters to fill that need. In the 4 years prior to the city's decision to close, we spent about $2 million assisting strays in St. Louis City. In the years since then, that cost has been more than $4 million. The increase was 97%. 52% of the stray animals that are brought to the Humane Society of Missouri from St. Louis City were first turned away by other city shelters. Every agency has to define their mission. And if their mission is very narrowly defined, then that may leave a lot of animals who are otherwise uncared for. Our Humane Society of Missouri Animal Cruelty Task Force is the only agency that will respond 24/7 to a call when an animal is sick or injured in St. Louis.
There was a stray on 44 one day, and I had to call the police and have them completely shut down the highway. And 44 is a pretty big highway, especially when you're here at Hampton, and they shut down the entire road. And I honestly thought the dog was dead because it was laying so still. And I opened up my driver's side door to get out and get the dog, and that dog jumped so quickly into my vehicle. He turned out to be fine. He was skinny, but I've never seen a dog immediately feel so glad just to be rescued, because I didn't even say anything to him. He just jumped straight into my car. This guy in the big picture was tied under a King's Highway overpass in kind of mid to South City. And someone just left him there. He had nothing. This guy under the wood pile, him and his friend was in an abandoned house in St. Louis, and we actually had to enlist the help of the fire department to get him out of the house. But he wouldn't leave his buddy, so we got both of them. And then the Chihuahua, that was one of the scariest things in recent memory that I had done. This Chihuahua was just a tiny little dog, was running down 270. And I remember getting the call thinking that there's no way this dog is here. There's no way somebody saw a Chihuahua running down 270. And I got there, and sure enough, the little dog was running down the median and scared to death. And again, had to call the police out, stop all the traffic on the highway so we could get this little dog.
You take one female cat and her offspring over the next 6 years, and you could end up with 67,000 unwanted animals. That's the difference one spay and neuter can make. So the solution to pet overpopulation is almost too simple. It's spay and neuter. We are the largest provider of that service in the state of Missouri. We do 10 to 12,000 spay and neuter surgeries each year. And that's where we're going to make a difference. $4 million is a lot of money. That would spay and neuter a lot of animals. But these are the efforts that we want to put into those animals so that they have a safe place to go. We want to make sure that those animals also get a second chance. So this is why it's so important that you act now, that we need your help to continue the good work that we're doing.
Hi, I'm Kathy Warnick. You just learned about the extremely challenging effects the stray animal crisis has had on the Humane Society of Missouri. In just 4 short years, the cost to rescue, care for, and find homes for these animals has increased 97%. This organization has always risen to the challenge of helping all animals in need. We do so without aid from tax dollars or other animal organizations. More than ever, we need your help. The cycle of pet overpopulation is truly heartbreaking. Spaying and neutering is the best and only real solution to the problem of stray animals. The Humane Society of Missouri is the largest provider of affordable, accessible spay-neuter services in Missouri. With your donations, we are able to offer spaying and neutering for just $20 to Missouri residents. And in the city of St. Louis, spaying and neutering is free. Each year, we perform more than 10,000 surgeries, but we have to do more. Please support our spay-neuter efforts by taking the Petco Foundation Spay-Neuter Challenge. All donations will be matched up to $20,000, so your gift counts double. Your generous donation to the Humane Society makes it possible for us to prevent literally millions of unwanted pets from being born each year. No animal should be left to roam the streets hungry and at risk of injury or abuse. Your donation of $100 pays for a complete spay or neuter surgery, and every dollar you donate will be matched by the Petco Foundation and a generous anonymous donor. Please help us promote responsible pet ownership and put an end to the stray animal crisis by making a generous gift toward our spay-neuter initiatives. Our toll-free number is 877-803-0078. Or you can make a secure donation on our website, hsmo.org. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Steph Duran. I do middays, 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. on the new Fresh 102.5. Please donate now to the Second Chances Telethon for the Humane Society of Missouri.
You just learned how the Humane Society of Missouri helps thousands of stray animals every year. Now let's meet one of them. Sparrow was just a tiny kitten when a good Samaritan found her. At only 2 pounds, she was too fragile to protect herself against the elements. She had also suffered a horrible eye injury and it needed to be surgically removed. Thankfully, the Humane Society of Missouri has the expertise to help a cat like Sparrow. Let's take a look at her transformation from injured stray to pampered pet.
You know, moving to a new city or any big transition in your life, I think sometimes having a companion, a furry friend, a cat or a dog in the home can make a big difference because they're always there, they always want you, they're calming, and they are also a distraction. They're a distraction maybe from the challenges you might be facing with a transition, and all they want is love, and that's so easy to give.
This is Sparrow, and she has white paws. She's very furry, and I think she's really nice. She has a little cute pink belly. It's a little big, but she's nice, and she has white under her chin. I like her.
My 10-year-old son has wanted a cat for about a year, and when we moved from Milwaukee to St. Louis, I told him that as soon as we bought a house, he could have a kitten. He was very specific about what he wanted. We went to several different rescues. We did a lot of research on the website looking for the right kitten, and we went to the Humane Society, and Hayden picked her out immediately. So we went to a meet and greet room and met Sparrow, and his reaction was, "Mom, I like her. Mom, I love her." And I asked what he thought about her eye, and I said, "Is the fact that she's missing her eye going to be an issue?" And he said, "Mom, it's just an eye, and it's not her fault." And which made me really proud.
Well, looking for an adoptable cat it's kind of hard because all the cats look cute.
Hayden was very specific about the kind of kitten that he wanted. One, he wanted a kitten, not a full-grown cat. He wanted a kitten that was still playful. So that's what he was looking for, and he was looking for, I think, truly a companion. Like I said, we moved to St. Louis just a few months ago, and we've always found that furry friends really make a house a home. And I think for younger children, kittens provide the companionship, the loyalty, the love, and the play without all of the work that come with a dog. So even though we have litter boxes and we have to feed and change water, it's not the same as taking a dog out for a walk, say in 13 degree weather. So they have some independence and sometimes a little bit more personality than dogs might. And I think that's what drew our son to a kitten.
I think cats are a little like nicer and they play. I know dogs play, but I think cats are like calmer and they aren't as destructive as dogs sometimes. And they are like a furry friend and they always stick by you if you're nice to them, and they are just like nice to you and they won't like bite you. They snuggle with you and stuff.
We had the easy job. When we got Sparrow, she was just waiting for love and a family to call home. And she fit right in. And going to the Humane Society, seeing an animal that may be overlooked because of a deformity or a missing limb, I was really proud of our son when he said, "It's not her fault," because he's right. And missing an eye makes her no less a cat than any other kitten sitting next to her. In some ways, it probably makes her more, because she's had a tough go of it, and with the love and attention that she gets in our house, she reciprocates that plus more. And I think sometimes an animal that's been rescued appreciates the love more than a kitten that from birth has been bred to be purchased. But we were amazed that somebody found her and brought her in, and the Humane Society made the effort to save her, because she is the sweetest, most loving and playful cat we could hope for. We had no idea that the Humane Society would go to the lengths that they do to save animals. You know, just like humans, physical ailments and disabilities can be fixed and worked with, and they are no less the animal despite their deficiencies.
You can't help but feel good when you see that cute little kitten living such a good life today. Her second chance was only possible because of donations from animal lovers like you. Please, help the Humane Society of Missouri so they never have to turn away an animal in need. Your gift of $25 provides a week's worth of food and care for 10 shelter pets. A generous gift of $100 helps pay for a special surgery. And don't forget, Scott Trade will match every donation up to $25,000. So call right now or donate securely online at hsmo.org.
Scott Trade knows our clients trade and invest their own way.
With Scott Trade Smart Techs, I can quickly understand my charts and spend more time trading. Their quick trade bar lets my account follow me online so I can react in real time. Plus, my local Scott Trade office is there to help, because they know I don't trade like everybody. I trade like me. I'm with Scott Trade.
Ranked highest in investor satisfaction with self-directed services by J.D. Power & Associates.
For the highest quality veterinary care, bring your pet to the Animal Medical Center of Mid-America. We have 3 locations open 6 days a week to serve you. Our nationally accredited veterinary practices feature state-of-the-art equipment and compassionate care from highly skilled doctors and technicians. Best of all, when you visit the Animal Medical Center of Mid-America, you're not only helping your pet, all proceeds benefit the Humane Society of Missouri, so you're helping many other pets in need. Visit us online at amcma.org and download a coupon for a complimentary first exam.
Here you go, Bear. Hold the football. Good job, Bear. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's the spot. That's the spot.
I'm Johnny Hecker, punter for the St. Louis Rams. This season, I was able to break records and go to the Pro Bowl thanks to hard work and the help of a great team. But there's another team I want you to know about, the Humane Society of Missouri's Animal Cruelty Task Force. Every day, they're out on the streets saving animals from abuse, animals like Bear. They have officers in St. Louis City and St. Louis County. In fact, they have officers helping animals throughout the entire state of Missouri. They do it 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year, but they can't do it without you. Join their team and fight animal cruelty by making a donation right now. Every dollar you donate stays in your community, so please, give generously, help animals like Bear get the second chance they deserve. Look at this face. How could you deny this face? Please donate.
Imagine if you had to live your life trapped in a small crate, no space to move or stretch, no toys, no treats, no love or affection. For sweet little Harley, this was her life for 3 entire years. She lived in a horrible puppy mill until the Humane Society of Missouri Animal Cruelty Task Force rescued her. Today, she has transformed from a terrified puppy mill survivor to an amazing happy dog. Watch to see how she went from filthy crate to big city living in the Loft District.
My Instagram and my Twitter are both Doxy House, because I have so many dachshunds. So I'm kind of a fan of them.
Come here. Come
on. They're sweet little dogs. They're very cuddly, but yet dachshund in German means badger dog. If you've ever seen a badger, they're kind of a vicious animal. So something so sweet could take out a badger. It's a sweet animal, but yet it's kind of vicious. She does have a little quirky thing about her at night when we go to sleep. She won't sleep without the food bowl. So I have to put it on the nightstand. There's something about she has to protect her food bowl. Otherwise she will jump out of bed and go sleep by the food bowl. From what I understand, she was in a crate for the first 3 years of her life. When I got her, she walked on her paws like they were completely spread out, so she didn't know how to walk on a solid surface at all. I can't even imagine what she looked like when they found her, when they pulled her out of that crate.
It was a cold day. Our rescue team had our insulated overalls on. It was a sunny day, but there was snow on the ground, there was ice on the ground, and the ground was semi-frozen, so the mud was semi-frozen, so you had to really be watchful of your step and just stepping. There were goats being contained in a muddy lot, and I guess one of the things that really caught my eye were the Great Pyrenees that were in open pens with simply dog-loo dog houses, which for a couple of them probably was not of adequate size. Their forelegs were coated with the mud up into their undercarriage. It was coated in mud, and they were somewhat fearful of people being there, so we had to take our time a little bit and warming up to these Great Pyrenees. The dachshunds were housed inside the residence, and there were a good number of them. Some were contained in crates, and some were running about and had the opportunity to be dachshunds, but you know, some were forced to live in those crates for extended periods of time. We saw about 80, between 80 and 90 dogs, between the dogs outside and the dogs in the house. We saw right at a dozen deceased dogs of varying ages in a pile out to the back of the residence. I've been doing this a very long time, and I've seen many, many rescues, and I think that I stopped looking at it from my, how do I judge this? And I put it back to the animals. For them, that is the worst situation. And your hopes is to get them out of their worst situation and to get them into a second chance.
I saw the story about a person that had over 80 dogs and 29 of them were dachshunds. When they finally posted their pictures online, I started looking through them. I stumbled upon this one in particular. There was something about her. She was just kind of an odd looking dog. And she had two different color eyes, and she was a dapple. They called her a blue merle, and she's all different colors. The next morning, as soon as they opened, I went down and I looked at her and I asked for this one in particular, and she brought her out, and I went into a little room with her, and I had her maybe 5 minutes in that room, and I knew that she was the one that had to come home with me. The first thing I did is I set her down on the floor so that the other dogs could play with her, and she stood in one place, and she stood in the same place for an hour. And it was really a sad moment because that's all she had done for 3 years was stood in the same place. You know, she was used to being penned up in that cage and not being able to go anywhere.
And animals that are contained in crates or very kennels or wire flooring or just a close confinement, it can be pretty scary coming out of there for the first time. Realize that there's something outside this box or there's something outside this wire crate. The adopters, bless their hearts, the ones that take these animals in, and they are patient with them, and they cultivate them from a cowardly lion, which is basically what they are when they come out of their forced environments, into an open and living environment and what life is all about. To see these animals come from this cowardly lion and blossom into this brave, happy, healthy, vibrant living creature is pretty remarkable.
We have always had a lot of toys at the house, and she didn't know what the toys were. She didn't have a clue that they were there for her to play with. But once she figured them out, she was all about the toys, and she kind of became a hoarder herself. She started stuffing them into her own crate, and she started stealing the remote controls and our cell phones and pretty much anything that wasn't nailed down in the house, she would stuff in her crate. Eventually, she, you know, kind of figured out what was hers and, you know, what was ours, and she became comfortable, and she's doing a lot better, but It was a very funny transition at first. I would say that if you're interested in getting a rescue, I would absolutely do it. They're wonderful animals, and you know, and the Humane Society is a great organization, and you know, they take wonderful care. They have wonderful veterinarians. They have wonderful staff, and I mean, they do a great job. And you know, I'm just happy that I found them.
What an incredible transformation for Harley, and all thanks to the Humane Society of Missouri Animal Cruelty Task Force and donations from people just like you. If you love animals as much as I love animals, I want you to pick up that phone right now and make a donation to help dogs like Harley. $50 pays for a veterinary exam so dogs like Harley can get the care they need. A donation of $100 buys some of the essential supplies for a big rescue like the one you just saw. And just for this program, Scott Trade will match your donation up to $25,000. Make a real difference for these animals and call right now. We've got so many great stories coming up for you. Stay tuned to meet a sweet chihuahua named Minnie and even some bunnies and goats who needed rescuing. We'll be right back after this.
Hi, I'm Jill Devine from Y98, and I'm so honored to be here to tell you that you can make a difference in a pet's life. My husband and I have our wonderful English bulldog. Her name is Apple, and we rescued her, and I just can't imagine her not being in our home. And the one reason why we decided to rescue her was to give her another chance. And so many dogs and cats and other animals out there, they're not given a second chance. They're thought of as throwaways, and that's not the case. These animals want to love you. They want to be loved. You can make a difference right now. Please give to the Second Chances Telethon for the Humane Society of Missouri.
Summer is cool at the Humane Society of Missouri. Do you know a child who loves animals? Register them for our Animal Adventure Day Camps. With a handful of exciting pet-themed programs, there's something for everyone. Spend an afternoon in our classroom learning about dogs, cats, and critters. Then visit with a furry friend from a Humane Society shelter. Every program features a hands-on activity and teaches important lessons about animal care. Space is limited. Register today at hsmo.org/education.
Welcome back to the Second Chances Telethon. I wanted to show you who showed up and is working the phone banks right now. Camo X's Mark Reardon is here. So what brings you here?
Well, my mom was gonna call, so let me see if I can get her real quick. Mom, not right now. I gotta talk to Virginia about animals and helping them out. No, I'm here because you know I love animals. Mm-hmm. I do, I have many of them. We call it, I don't know if you've ever seen some of my tweets, but we call it the Reardon Zoo at my house.
Zoo, yeah. And you have both cats and dogs.
I have cats and dogs, and they're all rescues, except for technically one might not be. Well, we sort of rescued our big black lab, Chase, because he was at a friend's house and needed a home. People didn't want them. There's so many animals that need homes, Virginia. It's tough for me because I'd take more if I could, and so would my wife. Becky certainly would.
Oh, so you don't get in trouble if you bring home like a foster animal or anything like that?
No, it's almost the opposite. She can't come into these situations where there are animals around because she wants to take them all home. So,
well, you obviously love animals, but specifically you're here helping the Humane Society of Missouri. Tell me about your relationship with them.
Well, I love the Humane Society. I think they do a great job. I mean, look, there are so many irresponsible pet owners, unfortunately, that leave their pets, and that's why we have to rescue those. Mm-hmm. And people with good hearts like myself and my wife and those of you out there can help the Humane Society. I've taken animals here that I've found in my neighborhood, and luckily a couple of them have been chipped. They've come in here. The Humane Society has helped me out. So they're there whenever you need them.
Well, and we tell these stories about these animal rescues like Trooper, the dog that was dragged behind the truck last year. And they're just miracle stories, but the way these miracles happen because of all the donations that come in.
Absolutely. I think people need to realize that this doesn't happen easily and by accident. There are a lot of volunteers. There are people here that help every day. It's a big operation.
Well, thank you for coming in.
Thank you for having
me. Call Mark. Mom,
yeah, please.
Call Mark.
No, someone other than Mom needs to call me right now and make a donation.
Thank you. We'll be right back.
Stella, have you lost weight? I'm telling you, it's this new cut.
You look pretty.
Don't I know it? Ah, wait till the boys at day camp get a look at us.
Kenilwood Pet Resorts. Grooming services and Shed-X treatments trusted by St. Louis's best-looking pets.
Visit our newest Kenilwood Spa location at the Humane Society of Missouri on Mackland Avenue, where your pet can enjoy a complete pampering spa experience.
When the Animal Cruelty Task Force received a call about a stray dog with a terrible leg injury, they wasted no time getting her the help she needed. And the Humane Society's Animal Medical Center of Mid-America was there to give that help. Rory's leg was too badly injured to be saved, but her life was saved by the staff and vets at the Humane Society. See how the Humane Society's talented veterinarians went above and beyond to give this shelter dog a second chance at finding her forever home.
Let's go, come on, let's go outside. Let's go, come on, let's go. Oh boy.
She does everything hard. She plays hard, she sleeps hard, she trained hard. She is just a puppy plus, and she's just getting to be better and better all the time.
There is no effect of her being disabled. She does anything and everything that any other dog can do.
The only thing is that she gets tired a little bit quicker because she's hopping everywhere instead of being able to walk. But she will play hard with not only her, quote, stepsisters, but also friends that will come over and bring their dogs. And she plays hard and loves it. She loves the backyard. It's not only is it a nice fenced-in yard that she can play, but she also has neighbors on all three sides. Two of those sides have children, and she loves children, absolutely adores the children. So next door, the children will come and stick their hand through the slots of the fence, and Rory will come and just lick everybody's hand as she walks along, and then she gets her pets. She loves to run and chase a ball. She loves to run and chase after Olive, the other dog, the peek-a-poo dog. And she also loves to steal tennis balls away from Bella, who is the golden retriever.
I had a professor in school tell us that all dogs were born with three legs and a spare. Dogs get along very, very well with three legs. And when you have a situation like that where you've got a leg that's beyond repair, then the best thing to do is remove it so that they can live a normal, healthy, happy life. And like I said, they hardly miss them.
You know, I have such hesitation about getting a dog that had a, quote, handicapped, realizing very quickly that I was the only person that could make her handicapped. And I would highly recommend anyone who sees a dog and has that little tug at their heart, but wants to push back because of a difficulty that they think they may have, to just take the leap, just try it. You know, there's that saying that you hear all the time about who saved who, and that's kind of how I feel about Rory. She has come into this house and has added laughter and love, and I can't even imagine a life anymore without her.
What an amazing story. Rory would not be here today if it wasn't for the Humane Society of Missouri. Their dedicated staff believes that all animals, no matter their medical issues, are deserving of a second chance. And joining me now is Dr. Kelly Ryan. She's the director of the Humane Society's Animal Medical Center of Mid-America. Dr. Ryan, tell me a little bit about the center.
The Animal Medical Center of Mid-America has actually three locations throughout St. Louis. We used to be known as the Veterinary Medical Centers of the Humane Society of Missouri, but we changed our name because people were thinking that we would only see shelter pets.
So you don't just see shelter pets?
No, we take care of anyone's pet. We would love to see them all.
Now, how do you help the Humane Society?
It is a really nice situation where all of our proceeds, because we are a nonprofit, all of the proceeds that the Animal Medical Center generates goes to help the sheltering pets, so all the pets looking for adoptable homes.
Well, as we just saw with Rory's story, you guys do some really complicated procedures here.
We do. We do all sorts of specialized surgeries, and we do lots of spays and neuters.
In fact, I read that you have done 300,000 spayed and neuter treatments.
Yes, since the 1970s, we've done over 300,000 spays and neuters for the pets in the community.
That is incredible. Yeah. So for the people watching right now, what would you like them to know about the center today?
I would just like them to know that our centers are here and that we would love to see their pets. Not only do we offer amazing quality medical care, but all the proceeds go to a great cause.
It sure does. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Well, please support the great work the Animal Medical Center of Mid-America does for pets in the shelter and in the St. Louis community. Make a donation to the Humane Society right now. Our toll-free number is 877-803-0078, or you can make a secure donation on our website, hsmo.org. Coming up next, we've shown you how the Humane Society of Missouri helps so many dogs and cats every year, but you may not know that they also have a 165-acre ranch dedicated to rescuing horses, goats, chickens, even pot-bellied pigs. It's coming up right after this.
One of the most responsible things you can do for your pet is to microchip them. This quick, painless procedure is one of the best ways to bring them home if they're ever lost. To celebrate the one-year anniversary of STL Lost Pets, the Humane Society of Missouri, APA of Missouri, and St. Louis County Animal Care are offering microchips for just $19.95 per pet. Find locations, appointment times, and information at stllostpets.org.
Scottrade knows our clients trade and invest their own way.
With Scottrade Smart Techs, I can quickly understand my charts and spend more time trading. Their quick trade bar lets my account follow me online so I can react in real time. Plus, my local Scottrade office is there to help. Because they know I don't trade like everybody. I trade like me. I'm with Scottrade.
Ranked highest in investor satisfaction with self-directed services by J.D. Power & Associates.